So in the lecture we've studied analog modulation techniques. We've studied the amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, and phase modulation. And nowadays, except for your radio stations, as far as I know, all modulation is digital. All our communication is digital. And there are advantages. There are obvious advantages of using digital. First advantage we know from 6002X, the famous chainsaw demo. Digital systems are more noise immune compared to analog systems. Two other advantages of digital communication are that you can encrypt digital data. Okay, so you can have different forms of you can secure your data. You have possibilities of compressing data, so you don't have to send a lot of information to transmit an image. You can compress the image. Since it's a digital image, you can compress the image. In case of audio, you don't have to send a huge wave format file. You can just send an MP3. So there are advantages of digital communication. Other advantages, the main advantage is noise immunity. So digital communication is what enables NASA to communicate with the Mars rover, for example. So you have very little signal power coming in from there, but we are still able to detect it. Okay, so if you're interested in that, you could look at receiver design. So that's an interesting topic as well. Anyway, so we're going to look at digital modulation. And why do we need modulation? We know two reasons already. One is to keep the antenna size practical. We know that if we have low frequency signals, our antennas need to be larger. But if you see a mobile phone, which also uses digital communication, so if you see a phone, the antenna in that is very tiny. Okay, it fits in your hand. So so that's one reason, to keep the antenna sizes practical. The other reason is to multiplex. Okay, so you need to send you should be able to send multiple messages. If you're in your neighborhood, a lot of people will have cell phones, not just 10 or 20. You'll have hundreds of people around you having cell phones, and your service provider needs to be able to cater to all of them at once, right? So you have modulation enables some sort of a multiplexing scheme. Okay, multiple access, rather. So multiple people are able to access the channel, as it is called, at the same time. The third reason is, if you remember, digital systems either have a zero or a one. Okay, you have almost abrupt changes between a zero and a one. But for an antenna to work, you need a continuously varying signal that comes from electromagnetic induction. You need a time varying signal for an antenna to radiate. Okay, and a digital signal isn't always time varying. It's either at zero or one, and the changes between zero and one are quite quick, and they need to be quick so that your communication is fast. So we use some sort of a modulation scheme, okay, where we use some sort of a sine wave, okay, some sort of a sine wave over some sort of a digital signal which is transmitted using a sine wave, that helps us communicate. So there are three forms of a digital modulation which I'm going to talk about, and they are analogous to the analog modulation schemes we've already studied. So the first one's called amplitude shift keying, okay, which is similar to analog amplitude modulation, okay, and it's ASK. The next one is frequency shift keying, which is similar to frequency modulation. Which is FSK. Okay. And finally, you have phase shift keying, which is actually quite important. PSK. A specific form of phase shift keying called QPSK, quadrature phase shift keying, is what is used nowadays. Okay, if I remember correctly, it's used in your mobile phones as well. So, in fact, it's used even in the current networks, 3G, 4G. I could be wrong there, but if I remember correctly, it's used. It's called QPSK, quadrature phase shift keying. You can read about it. Okay, I'm going to discuss these three today. Okay, and I'm going to use Octave to explain what each of these are. I'm just going to show you the waveform, and you'll understand how to generate it. I'm not going to show any circuit or anything. So let's just get right into it. So again in octave I need a time scale, so I'm going to keep a time scale from 0 to 20. Okay, I already have a carrier. Okay, my carrier is C1 equal to this, so I'll just plot my carrier. Okay, and you can see this is a sine wave. Okay, simple sine wave of some sort of frequency. Okay, some frequency sine wave. I have a C2 which is of a higher frequency. I've already generated these signals so that the tutorial can be quick. Okay, so this is C2 which is of a higher frequency, and I have a message signal which is called just message. It's G. Sorry. And this is my message signal. It's a square wave. I can just use axis and axis. So you can see that it's a simple square wave. Okay, so from 0 to 1, it just keeps varying. And the first form of modulation is an AX, is called ASK. Very simple to implement. You just take your message signal, multiply it with the carrier. So you can just say ASK. You can just see I've just multiplied the carrier with my message signal. Okay, so I will say plot ASK. Okay, and just to see it a little more closely. Okay, just to see the signal more closely, I'm going to just modify the axis. You can see whenever the signal is high. Okay, whenever the signal is high, you see a sine wave being transmitted. If it's low, there's no sine wave. Again, when there's a one, so let me just plot. Let me do a subplot. Okay, so subplot 2, 1, 1. Okay, and I'll say plot ASK and subplot 2, 1, 2. Oops. And I'll plot the message. Okay. And let me change my axis to this. Okay, so you can see these values. Let me just do the subplot of the first one as well. Oops. Okay, sorry for the confusion. Axis, yeah, so this should do it for me. Yeah, so you can see whenever the message signal is 1, you can see the sine wave being transmitted. Whenever there's a 0, there's nothing. Again, when there's 1, so that's ASK. Very simple modulation. I'm not going to go into the math or any of the details. You can look up any digital communication book. It'll be explained very well there. My purpose was just to introduce you to these techniques. So this is amplitude shift keying. In frequency shift keying, what we do is we take two different carriers. So when there is a 1, we use one particular carrier. When there's a 0, there's another carrier. Okay, so let's look at that now. And to generate an FSK, what I do is I take the message, I multiply it by the carrier, I take the inverse of the message, and I multiply it by the carrier again. Okay, and let's just do that. Okay, and in my subplot 1, okay, it's already on subplot 1, so I'll just plot my FSK. Okay, and if you look at this, okay, again, let me just change the axis. If you look at the signal, so at whenever it is a 1, you have one particular frequency. When it goes to 0, it shifts to a different frequency. So you have a frequency shifting every time, and this is FSK, okay, frequency shift keying. This is obviously preferred over amplitude shift keying, because amplitude shift keying again involves changing of the amplitude, and anything that involves changing of amplitude is not desired amplitude scheme, because amplitude is not a desired modulation scheme, because whenever you have noise is always additive. Okay, so noise will always change the amplitude. Okay, so we want something that is independent of the amplitude level, and frequency shift keying is independent of the amplitude level. Okay, so this is frequency shift keying. So finally, I'm just going to demonstrate phase shift keying, and I'll wrap it up by just giving you a block diagram of each case. Okay, so phase shift keying is very simple. Give me a minute. So phase shift keying is simple again. The only difference is we need a polar message signal. And what I mean by polar is a 1 is 5 volts, for example, but the zero should be negative 5 volts. It cannot be zero. Okay, so that's quite simple. In octave, all I need to do is subtract 0.5 and then scale it by multiplying it by 2. Okay, and that's what I get. And a PSK is again very simple. Just multiply that with a carrier. Multiply the polar signal with a carrier, and that's all you have. And if I check the, if I do a subplot, okay, and if I say plot PSK, let me plot PSK, and I'll do subplot 2, 2, 2. Or before that, let me change the axis. Okay, and now I'll say subplot 2, 2, 2, and I will say plot message polar, and I'll again change the axis. Okay, and you can see that if I just zoom in, if I just zoom in here, you can see whenever there is a change in the bit value, okay, there's a change in phase. So let me just go back there. Give me a minute. Okay, I'll just change the axis again, so that it's looks better. Subplot. Okay, so you can see when it changes from 1 to 0, the phase changes at the negative region. But when it changes from 0 to 1, it changes at the positive region. So this is PSK. Okay, phase shift keying. Again, this is more desirable than amplitude shift keying, because it does not depend on the amplitude level. It depends on phase, and noise cannot change phase. It can only change amplitude. Okay, so these are the three modulation schemes. There are others, and just to look at the block diagram to just show you what I did. Just to show you what I did. In ASK, what I do is I take the signal. Okay, take the signal. Okay, just multiply it with the carrier, okay, carrier, and I get my ASK. So this is ASK, very simple. Okay, in FSK, I take my signal again. Where is my paintbrush? Okay, I take the same signal again. I also shift my signal. I delay my signal. So I delay it. So a delay is denoted by, so I'll just delay my signal, so I have some sort of a delay, and the delay is very important. You need the right kind of delay. Okay, Z is used for delay. Z inverse, if I remember. Okay, we'll learn that in Z transforms anyway. So Z inverse stands for delay, and I multiply this by one signal, one carrier. I multiply this with another carrier, C2, C1, C2, and then I add the two together. Okay, so this is FSK, and you can think of ways to implement this in a circuit. Okay, probably an exercise for this week. And finally, QPSK, which is quite similar to FSK, similar to ASK, the circuit is quite similar. You again have a signal. What's important is the signal is polar. Okay, polar. Okay, this is very important. Okay, you need a polar signal for PSK. Again, you multiplied this with a carrier, and you'll end up getting a PSK. And these are the three modulation schemes in the digital domain.